In this problem, we want to compress a real gas, a non-ideal gas, carbon dioxide, that's initially at 175 degrees and 20 bar. We want to compress to 275 bar, and we want to do this isothermally, so it's 175 degrees. We want to determine what's the final volume, what's the internal energy change, the entropy change, the work done to compress the gas, and the total heat transfer during compression. And we're going to model CO2 by the Peng-Robinson equation state, and we're going to use a spreadsheet that's described in a separate screencast to determine the values, and then we're going to use the values in the calculations. So what I'm going to show you now is the values that I've read off the spreadsheet. So the spreadsheet used the Peng-Robinson equation of state to get the volume, internal energy, and the entropy. We're interested in the final volume, where we start with 1 cubic meter, a very large container. And so what we need to determine, since these are values of volume per mole, we need to determine the number of moles in our system. That's the first step, and the number of moles is not going to change. So that's going to be the total volume of our system divided by the volume per mole when we start it. So I'm going to convert this from cubic meters to cubic centimeters to be consistent with the value from the spreadsheet. So the number of moles initially, and the number of moles, of course, finally, 551. So we need that value to calculate the final volume in our container. So the final volume, we should have called this volume one, the total initial volume. The total final volume would be the number of moles times the volume per mole. So 551 moles. And then we read off the table that we have 112.6 cubic centimeters per mole. We're going to multiply these two to get our final volume. We have the final volume, then I converted it back to cubic meters and just wrote down two significant figures. Next, we want to calculate delta U. So delta U total, it's going to be number of moles, U2 minus U1, where U2 and U1 are the kilojoules per mole that we obtained from the spreadsheet. So let me substitute the values in. So I've substituted the values, and then the important thing to point out is, if this were an ideal gas, and for an ideal gas, isothermally, delta U would be zero. So notice that we have an internal energy change for the real gas. We would not have this for an ideal gas. Next thing we want to calculate is the entropy change. So we're going to do the same type calculation. We're going to calculate the total entropy change as the number of moles, S2 minus S1. The value of state functions, we just need initial and final conditions independent of the path to do this. So let me substitute the numbers in here. Again, I reduced the number of significant figures, converted this from joules to kilojoules. The entropy is decreasing, kept it isothermal, but we've decreased the volume, increased the pressure, so that should result in a decrease in entropy. Now, the last two parts, we're going to have to make assumptions. It asks what the heat and work is. And so to do that calculation, we'd have to assume it's done reversibly. Otherwise, we have no way of determining it. So what we're calculating then is the work reversible and the heat transfer reversible. The heat transfer reversible is what we can calculate first, because that's going to be the temperature, since it's isothermal, times the total entropy change. So, of course, the temperature has to be an absolute temperature, Kelvin, and the delta S total that we just calculated. And so Q is negative. This says, as we expect, we have to remove heat. We're doing work on the system when we compress it, but since we're keeping it isothermal, we have to remove heat in order to satisfy the first law. And so delta U total would be Q total plus W total. And we know now delta U and Q, so W total is just delta U total minus Q total. So let's substitute in those two values. And so we have the work total, and we might round this to 5,100 kilojoules. Notice this is positive because we did work on the system in compressing it. We've now calculated the work and the heat for reversible. So it's important to emphasize that we assume this was reversible in order to calculate the work and heat. Otherwise, we need more information. The other thing to point out, when we have a non-ideal gas, modeling it in this case with the Peng-Robinson equation of state, then delta U is not zero for an isothermal process.